Hello and welcome to Yeyu Lab. Since we have gone through quite many tutorials about the framework of AutoJ, it's time to look at some tricks to help you create a practical app. Today we will talk about useful field description, which helps you to effectively organize a group chat. Right now, when a bunch of agents need to talk to each other, people usually create a group chat manager to manage them in a group chat. If you are developing a real-world AutoJ project with multiple agents to complete complex tasks, you'll quickly find that managing the flow of their speaking is critical. It's not simply about what expertise they have or what content they should generate. It's about ensuring they speak at the right time to make the conversation coherent and purposeful. Without careful management, the conversation can become chaotic, with agents talk over each other or out of turn, which costs much on tokens but cannot generate satisfied output. Orchestrating the conversation effectively is challenging, especially with the complexity of tasks and roles of agents, and even more challenging when you require jumping input as a human approval. This is where the importance of orchestration by description within the framework comes into play. Before version 0.2.2 of AutoJ, Group Chat Manager would look at an agent's system message and name to figure out what it does. This was okay if the AutoJ system message was short and to the point and without any special request, but it got messy if the system message was trying to guide the agents to collaborate with each other. And the version 0.2.2 update brings in a description field for all the agents, which replaces the system message in group chat for group member recognition. If you leave the description empty, the orchestrator will still use the system message for conversation orchestration. Please note that even the orchestrator does not rely on system message. It is a must field as agents use it for their own system prompts. You can find AutoGen's official blog post for more details about the template's difference between old and new orchestration. The new template for Chat Manager is quite concise and effective. Next, we will create an automated conversation workflow in a well-designed experiment to examine the benefits of this field, which I think is more intuitive than the one in their blog post. Let me first introduce the design of this experiment. In this experiment, we are going to create a group chat app that helps the user to generate a travel plan. In this group chat, we aim to create an automated conversation workflow that generates custom travel plans and insurance packages for given locations and dates. The system includes several AI agents. The first one is Web Reporter, who provides the weather conditions based on the locations and dates. As the function calling feature is not related to today's topic, so we ask the assistant to use its training knowledge to provide the historical data. The second one is Activity Agent, who provides recommendations for travel activities based on the location and weather conditions. The third one is Travel Advisor, who generates a travel plan, including everyday's activities. The last one is Insurance Agent, who recommends insurance options tailored to the planned activities and potential risks. To be more specific, the sequence of the speaking should be designed to follow weather reporter to activity agents to travel advisor to insurance agent. Now let's write the code and compare the results. First, let's create a legacy program without any description field. We will construct these agents with legacy system messages. Step 1, install the AutoJ package first. Pipe install PyAutoJ. Step 2, define the LLM config. In this case, I'm using GPT 3.5 model instead of the GPT 4 because most AutoJ developers will use GPT 3.5 for its faster generation and lower cost. And using GPT 3.5 is easier to expose the defects of orchestration by system messages. Next step, we will construct the user proxy. We don't really need the user proxy for human interaction or code execution in this case, so just simply copy. Now we should construct the four AI agents. We should start building these agents with the proper system message to guide what content they should generate. For the weather reporter, you are a web reporter who provides weather overall status based on the dates and the location the user provided. Using historical data is okay. Make your response short. The activity agent, you are an activity agent who recommends activities considering the weather situation from weather reporter. And don't ask questions, make your response short. The insurance agent, you are an insurance agent who gives the short insurance items based on the travel plan. Don't ask questions, make your response short. The travel advisor, after activities recommendations generated by activity agent, you generate a concise travel plan by consolidating the activities. In the system messages, we instruct clearly to each agent what other's output needs to be referred, like considering the weather situation from weather reporter, based on the travel plan, after activities recommendation generated by activity agent, which looks quite obvious to these GPT 3.5 powered agents to follow. Note that we also ask the agents to keep output short to make a clearer demonstration. Put all the agents into a group chat to create a manager to orchestrate them. Then give the user a request for generating a travel plan to Bohol Island in Philippines in September. Now let's wrap up and run the app to see the print. Unfortunately, you can find that the speaker selection process is not what we expected. The actual speaking order is weather reporter, then travel advisor, and then to insurance agent and to activity agent. The travel advisor directly generates the travel plan without waiting for the activity items generated by the activity agent. That was normally happening when I developed the AutoGen projects for my client, which is far more complicated than this example, and even worse when includes human interaction under certain conditions. Okay, now let's use description field by an additional step to the above code to equip these agents with proper descriptions. Here, you should carefully review your descriptions to make sure there is no you in the content, like the system prompt, and instead use the name of the agents directly or use this agent so that the orchestrator will clearly understand who is the next speaker. Moreover, you should keep it as short as you can to save tokens, since the description will be prompted to the model every time before the next speak. To make the comparison fair enough, you can find that I have only replaced the you with this agent and not changing anything else. This slight code change will definitely correct the output. Let's look at the print. Now the speaking order finally meets our requirements. It's weather reporter, activity agent, travel advisor, and insurance agent. If you know enough about AutoGen, you may suggest setting the speaker selection method field to value round robin in the group chat object, which iterates the speaking in the same order as provided in our previous agent's definition. I admit that this will be a simpler approach to make the speaking order strictly fixed. However, when the orchestrator encounters more complicated cases, like when some agents need to speak again under certain conditions or accept casual human inputs, only description can work. Let me add more requirements to the group chat to prove that. After the original conversation finished, I would like a human interaction for approval of the insurance items. And upon approval, the travel advisor will generate again with an updated version of the plan by including the insurance information. To make that happen, we should first change the user proxy agent a bit. Here, the human input mode field is set to always to allow user input during group chat. Then append the text. The insurance items must be sent to user proxy for human review to the description of the insurance agent. In the last step, we modify the description of a travel advisor for an update of a new plan. Here we ask the agent to, after the user proxy approves insurance items generated by insurance agent, this agent should generate an updated travel plan by including the original plan and the insurance content. Let's see the result. It's going well. It asked me to give an input and approved, and then the travel advisor gave the updated plan. Even it's very simple because nothing need to be updated. That's all for today. For the tutorial and the source code, you can find the link in the description below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Keep innovating, and I'll catch you in the next one.